Hello everyone, welcome to the semicolon. This tutorial is a part of the series Data Analytics with Python. Today we're going to learn about NumPy and Matplotlib libraries. NumPy is an extension to Python which adds multidimensional array support to Python. The NumPy arrays come in really handy for data analytics purposes. Apart from data analytics, one of the important roles of data scientist is to visualize data, and Matplotlib is a library which gives us the superpowers to plot beautiful graphs. Let's have a brief look at both of these in this video. Let's start learning about the NumPy library. We import the NumPy library by typing import NumPy as np. Now we can call all the functions of NumPy library by using np. We create a list of some numbers and then pass it to the function np.array. So what we have now is a NumPy array. So when we multiply it by a scalar, it looks something like this. It gets multiplied, each and every element gets multiplied by the scalar. If you multiply it with the array, with the NumPy array of same dimension, then it is element wise multiplication, which you can try it yourself. Now let's try to generate a sequence of numbers using the arrange function. When we pass two integers to the arrange function, the first integer is the starting point and the last integer, which is not included, is the ending point. So we get, when we pass 1 and 10, we get the numbers from 1 to 9. And if we want to generate numbers with a constant distance, then we just have to type one more, we just have to pass in one more parameter which gives the distance. So let's generate numbers from 0.1 to 1.2 and give the gap as 0.1. So we get all the numbers from 0.1 to 1.1 with a gap of 0.1. Now let's look at how we create multidimensional arrays. So we pass a list of lists through the same function np.array, store it in B. So what we have is our own NumPy array, which is multidimensional. So you can check the dimensionality of array by typing b.ndim, and also you can do the same thing with A. So the dimension of B is 2 and the dimension of A is 1. Now we can also calculate the shape of the NumPy array by passing it through the shape function np.shape, and B is a 2x2 array, as you could see when we printed it out, and A is a 4x1 array. So this is how we can check the shape and dimension of our arrays. Now let's see how we can access the values from the indexing. When we pass in one value, or the first value, the first index, it is for the rows. So B of 0 gives us the row, B of 1 would give us the second row, B of 0 gave us the first row. And if we type another indexing, another layer of indexing, B of 0 of 0, we get the first element of the first row. And we can select a range of indexes as well. By typing 1:3, we get the numbers which are indexed at 1 and 2. So 3 is not included, as in NumPy the ending point is not generally included. So now let's look at how we generate random numbers. We type np.random.randn and pass in the size of the matrix in which we want to generate our random number. And this is what we have as our random matrix. Let's start learning about the Matplotlib library. So Matplotlib is a very important library for plotting graphs and is very important in data visualization. We import matplotlib.pyplot as plt. And then when we want to plot a graph, we create a list and pass it through plt.plot. And if we do not pass the list, it shows an empty graph. But then when we pass on the list, this is what we have. It plots the points to the y-axis by default when we do not pass the points in the x-axis. You can change the labels of x-axis and y-axis using the functions plt.ylabel and passing the label as a string. And you can do the same thing with x-axis as well. We You can also pass in the points of y-x-axis. The first list is generally considered as the points of a x-axis, and the second list is considered as the points in y-axis. And when we pass it through the plot function, this is how our graph looks like. So we can again add x label, y label, or you could change the dimensions of the axis. So you have to pass a list through the axis function, and the first two elements of the list represents the range of the x-axis, and the next two elements of the list represents the range of the y-axis. So this is what our graph looks like after we incorporate the change in axis. Then you can plot points instead of a straight line, and we can specify color by using R, B, G, and specify the shape using O. So when we type R, O, we get red circles as points. When we type R minus, we get connected lines. And when we type R and the symbol, which is used to represent power or exponent, we get triangles. You can replace R with B and G as well to get red, blue, and green colors. So this is how it looks like when we can color our graph. You can also plot multiple graphs with different colors. Let's plot A with A square with red circles. And this is how our graph looks like. Then let's add A and A cube and plot it with blue triangles. And you have to pass it in string, and that is why the error. And this is how two graphs looks together. You can pass in two graphs through the pyplot function. You can change the shape, color, and everything. So this is what we have for the Matplotlib library, which will be useful for our course with data analytics. Hit the like button if you enjoyed this video. Hit the subscribe button if you want to keep watching more and more of videos like this. Thank you.